Through my presentation, I will explain the topic cradle-to-cradle design or C2C design. What is cradle-to-cradle approach? Basically, cradle-to-cradle approach is a biomimetic approach to the design of products and systems that models human industry on nature's processes, where materials are viewed as nutrients circulating in healthy and safe metabolism. Actually, the term itself is a play on the popular phrase cradle to grave, implying that this C2C model is sustainable and considerate of life and future generations, from the birth or cradle of one generation to the next generation versus from birth to death or grave within the same generation. C2C model, it suggests that industry must protect and enrich ecosystem and nature's biological metabolism. It is a holistic, economic, industrial and social framework that seeks to create systems that are not only efficient but also eventually waste-free. Origin of C2C design. This cradle-to-cradle concept is not a new concept. Walter Strehill has been credited with using this term cradle-to-cradle as early in the 1980s. He also mentioned a similar process in his 1976 research paper, The Potential for Substituting Manpower for Energy. However, major credit goes to William McDonough, a sustainable architect, and Michael Brongard, a chemist, who were instrumental in the design and development of this current concept of cradle-to-cradle in 2002. They co-authored a book entitled Cradle-to-Cradle and charted a film, McDonough-Brongard Design Chemistry, dedicated to this concept, and they have become leading experts on this subject. Cradle-to-Cradle, Remaking the Way We Make Things by William McDonough and Michael Brongard. This book, it presents the reader with an explanation for why humans need a completely new agenda for how we interact with the world around us. The subject of this book revolves around the idea that in nature, waste equals food. All products, they are seen as nutrients within biological or industrial metabolism. It presents the methodology that C2C model, it builds on the concept that waste equals to food. Meaning, what is considered waste can become a food in a new product cycle. See, it is about seeing garbage as an internal resource and doing right from the beginning itself. Technical and biological nutrients. In the cradle-to-cradle model, all materials used in industrial or commercial processes such as metals, fibers, dyes, they fall into one of the two categories, technical or biological nutrients. First, technical nutrients. Technical nutrients are basically inorganic or synthetic materials manufactured by humans, such as plastics and metals, that can be used many times over without any loss in quality, staying in a continuous cycle. These nutrients are strictly limited to non-toxic, non-harmful synthetic materials that have no negative effects on the natural environment. They can be used in continuous cycles as the same product without losing their integrity or quality. In this manner, these materials can be used over and over instead of being downcycled into lesser products, ultimately becoming waste. Second, biological nutrients. Biological nutrients and materials, they are organic materials that can decompose into the natural environment, soil, water, etc. without affecting it in a negative way, providing food for bacteria and microbiological life. See, biological nutrients are organic materials that once used they can be decomposed in any natural environment and they decompose into the soil, providing food for small life forms without affecting the natural environment. This is dependent on the ecology of the region. For example, organic materials from one country on landmass may be harmful to the ecology of another country or landmark. Cradle to grave and cradle to cradle concepts. Two of the most basic terms in the eco-design field, they are cradle to cradle and cradle to grave. They relate to the product life cycle from the raw materials, that is cradle, to disposal, that is grave. First, cradle to grave concept. It is a term used in life cycle analysis to describe the entire life of a material or a product up to the point of disposal. Our current recycling methods, they are inefficient and they only serve to maintain this cradle-to-grave routine that has been in use for hundreds of years. Second, cradle-to-cradle concept. It is a model of industrial system in which material flows cyclically in appropriate, continuous, biological or technical nutrient cycles. All waste materials, they are productively reincorporated into new production and use phases. That is, waste equals food. Implementation of C2C design. The C2C model, it can be applied to almost any system in modern society, be it urban environments, buildings, manufacturing, social systems, etc. 5 steps are outlined in the Cradle to Cradle Remaking the Way We Make Things book. And these 5 steps are: first step, get free of known culprits. Second step, follow informed personal preferences. Third step, create passion positive list, meaning list of materials used categorized according to safety levels, like the X list. It contains the substances that must be phased out, such as mutagenic, carcinogenic and tetrogenic. Second, the gray list, problematic substances that are not so urgently in need of phasing out. And third, the P list, it contains this positive list substances actively which are defined as safe for use. The fourth step is to activate the positive list, and the fifth step is reinvent the design of the former system. Some major implementations of the C2C design they are given here. It includes the Lyle Center for Regenerative Studies, which incorporates holistic and cyclic systems throughout the center. Regenerative design is arguably the foundation for the trademark C2C. Also, the government of China contributed to the construction of the city of Huang Bayou based on the C2C principles, utilizing the rooftops for agriculture. The Fort River Work Complex redevelopment, cleaning 20 billion US gallons of rainwater annually, it also used the C2C model. The Netherlands Institute of Ecology, it planned to make its laboratory and office complex completely cradle-to-cradle compliant, including several private houses and communal buildings. And Fashion Positive, an initiative to assist the fashion world in implementing the cradle-to-cradle model in 5 areas: material health, material reuse, renewable energy, water stewardship and social fairness. The concept of cradle-to-cradle carpeting. The Environmental Protection Encouragement Agency, EPEA, founded in 1987, it assists in the development of C2C compliant products. And carpets, they have proven to be one of the suitable C2C candidates. Europe, it produces about 400,000 tons of carpets per year. And almost all of the used carpets, they end up in landfills or they are incinerated. So, the company succeeded in developing a C2C technology to produce and recycle carpets that are C2C compliant. And this was made possible by the creation of the Euro C2C Carpet Chain Project, an EU-funded research project coordinated by Daimans, which ended in June 2013. And as a part of this project, a target to recycle 4% of the total discarded carpets per year in Europe was set. Currently, the recycling is done with DESO's innovative separation technique called Refinity, the only pilot C2C plant in Europe for recycling carpets. Thank you for watching my presentation.